Hello everyone. In this video, we'll show how to implement Simultaneous Localization and Mapping, or SLAM, on aerial LiDAR point cloud. We'll be using point cloud data stream from LiDAR sensor mounted on a UAV in a simulation environment. MATLAB provides broad range of simulation environments which can be used to implement similar workflows in different application areas. Automated Driving Toolbox and UAV Toolbox contains Unreal-based simulators and cuboid simulation environments. And there is Roadrunner to create static objects for Unreal simulation environment. In this example, we'll use simulation environment available in UAV Toolbox. Our workflow starts with simulating the city environment with a UAV in it. We'll then stream LiDAR data from the simulated LiDAR model to a MATLAB system. After that, we'll register point clouds based on feature descriptors extracted from each point cloud. Finally, we'll implement post-draft optimization to correct the drifts that have happened in the registration step and build the complete map. Let's start with simulating the environment. We'll make use of a city simulation containing lots of roads and buildings. We'll first define a trajectory for our UAV. Note that two trajectory loops have been utilized to ensure loop closure, which is useful in post-graph optimization. We are using a Simulink model to perform this simulation. We can now load the Simulink model by running this script. There are four main parts to the Simulink model. First one is the simulation 3D scene configuration block. You can find this block from the Simulink library by searching simulation 3D scene. This configures the scene to the US city block that we saw earlier. The second block is our simulation 3D UAV vehicle model. This places our UAV on the scene and moves it through the trajectory using the X, Y, Z and yaw data we loaded before. The third block upon the top is the simulation 3D LiDAR block. We are using the LiDAR model available in UAV Toolbox for this example. This mounts a LiDAR sensor on top of our UAV. You can select the sensor and configure the parameters like distance range, range resolution, field of view, etc. And the fourth block we have is our MATLAB system. Here, we'll process the LiDAR data from the sensor to iteratively create the map. Now let's run our simulation. Running the simulation shows the UAV flying on the predefined trajectory and capturing live LiDAR data. The MATLAB system block in our Simulink model collects this data and stitches it together to build the map of the arena. Before I explain how the MATLAB system block operates, I'll briefly explain point cloud registration. Point cloud registration is the process of stitching multiple point clouds to create a combined bigger point cloud. If we have point cloud data and accurate post data for each instances, we can use the post info to stitch the point cloud. But this is not always the case. Our post info will not be that accurate. So here, I'll show how to create the 3D map with only point cloud data in MATLAB. We first read two consecutive point clouds and then do some basic pre-processing like ground removal and downsampling. After that, we'll extract FPFH descriptors from both point clouds using extract FPFH features function. Then to match them, we'll use PC match feature function. Here you can see that we have two point clouds in red and blue colors, and the match features are connected with yellow lines. Now we'll use these matched features to estimate the transformation between point clouds using estimate geometric transform 3D function. This will give us the rigid transformation between the point clouds. We'll use PC align function to align these point clouds using the rigid transformation matrix. Here is our aligned point cloud based on the matched features. This is what is happening in the MATLAB system block. It uses the point cloud registration functions for pre-processing, extracting and matching FPFH descriptors, estimating the transformation, and aligning the point clouds. We'll do this for every third point cloud that is fed into the MATLAB system. This accelerates the processing and accumulates enough motion between the scans. Once the simulation is complete, we can see that the map is not aligned properly. This is because there were minor drifts in each registration steps, which then accumulated over time when we built the map. We'll now apply post-draft optimization to correct these drifts and build the map properly. Post-draft optimization is a separate topic by its own. Due to time constraints, I would recommend you to watch this MATLAB tech talk. It explains post-draft optimization and how it will help to have a better estimate of the current and past posts and a better model of the environment. So here is our final output after post-draft optimization. You can see our optimized waypoint poses in the red color, and the map is now aligned properly. It's much cleaner than the one which we got earlier, and it resembles our actual arena. This concludes the aerial LiDAR SLAM workflow. If you have any questions or comments, please let us know.